Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, we're going to give you an overview about Cisco's Contact Center global deployment. Cisco has deployed Contact Center as of May 22 in one of these following countries. You got the United States, Canada, Frankfurt, United Kingdom, Australia, and Japan. In each one of these locations, you have various different type of application stack or component that are running. Now, if you follow the color coding here, you'll see that anything with a ping that indicates that where they're located, that's called application data center. An application data center is located in the United States, in Germany, Australia, United Kingdom, but not located in Canada or Japan. But what you have in Canada, for example, you have the WebEx Contact Center data center, or you could have, you have the Calabrio data center, you have workflow management data centers. So each one of these location will have, like some of this location will have certain component that may be deployed to serve that region. So in Frankfurt, for example, most of these countries will probably register with the data center that is located in Ireland. Whereas India could be served by, India does have something what they call the data center for Calabrio, and United Calabrio will be covering in India, United States, and a few, pretty much that's it. Canada is covered by Canada, pretty much. I got my own, you know, we got everything on there ourselves, as you can see. It is, however, coming in the fourth quarter of this year, 2022. And for Japan, for example, you do have something called the virtual POP, or voice POP, not virtual POP. So this is the global reach of the data center. There are certain countries that are permitted to sell in a country. However, they will not include the PSTN bundle. Data centers are based on the country selected while mapping the contact center in order to customer organization. So you can select which data center you want by going to the commerce.cisco.webex.com. Tenant gets to create the closest regional data center based on your country. So for example, if you're in Europe, most likely you will either choose UK or Germany. If you're in India, you could choose either Germany or maybe Japan or Australia. If you're in Japan, you could choose the US data center. Mexico, you will choose the US data center as well. Now, for data residency, it is very important that every country, or pretty much most country, have some sort of regulation for data. Now, when it comes to data, we're talking about the voice conversation most of the time. But of course, you have your chat integration, chat conversation, Teams conversations. You want to be able to save them into the appropriate countries. Now, which country? Well, this virtually not, well, not virtually, but it is very long list of countries that have a regulation for each. So you want to be able to find that information out by going to this website. However, for example, in US, they have a rule that all data related to US citizen or resident should be stored in US. Like that, you have countries like India, China, or UK. They all have their own regulations. So your data should be stored into the appropriate countries that you must follow. Otherwise, there could be a serious legal issues from business perspective. Localization, you can customize the agent desktop management portal analyzer with your local languages. Up to 6 different languages is supported. For example, English, Japanese, France, German, Italy, and Spain. These are the language currently supported. So, like I said, there are many different components that are running within your WebEx contact center. You have something called Cube, which is very popular, unified border element from Cisco. You have on-premise connectivity with the call manager. You have enterprise premises, access network. So make sure you're familiar with these terms, because when you are working with partner or when you're working with a Cisco sales team, they will probably use this term and jargon, and you should be familiar with them. What each one of these terms means and where they are used and deployed, so that you know exactly where to look for, or what to look for if you heard one of these conventions. Now, there are various terminologies, as I say, Cisco contact center will be identified WXCC, WXC, which is Cisco WebEx calling, CCP, which is cloud connected part, PSTN, LGW, which is local gateway, Cube, Cisco Unified Border Element, and so on and so. This terminology does help you understand your environment or even read a documentation, knowing that what they will be, what their purposes are. All right, so that's pretty much the end of this chapter, and including the end of our first discussion about the overview of Cisco WebEx Contact Center. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.